Hi, my name is Katie Purcell. I'm an applications engineer here at Achronix, and today I'm going to introduce you to Achronix's Network on Chip, or NoC. Modern systems using FPGAs now require high-speed interfaces and large memory bandwidth, making the efficient movement of data in and around an FPGA of paramount importance. For example, Achronix's Speedster7t 1500 device has four 400 gig Ethernet MACs that can move up to 1.6 terabits per second, a 16-lane PCIe Gen 5 with up to 512 gigabits per second, and eight GDDR6 controllers plus DDR4 that can produce up to 4.5 terabits per second. So how can we move these massive amounts of data around the FPGA efficiently? Achronix's solution is a two-dimensional hierarchical network-on-chip, or NoC, that connects all the high-speed IP interfaces and overlays on top of the FPGA fabric. This provides for up to 20 terabits per second of bidirectional bandwidth between points in the FPGA fabric and the various IP interfaces, including GDDR6, 400 gig Ethernet, PCIe Gen 5, and DDR4. The NoC handles address decoding and translation, any clock domain crossing, as well as transaction arbitration. With its simple-to-use AXI or data streaming interfaces, it significantly reduces both design time and the FPGA resources needed to allow users to connect their FPGA logic to IP interfaces, create point-to-point connections within the FPGA fabric, and even communicate between IP interfaces without using any FPGA fabric resources. Let's look at what a design normally requires in a traditional FPGA without a network on chip. Say, for example, you want to design two hardware accelerators in your FPGA to talk to GDDR6 memories. Along with the logic for the hardware accelerators, a user also needs to design crossbar logic to handle address decoding, flow control, and transaction arbitration. Additionally, the user will need to design any clock domain crossing FIFOs and the logic needed to talk to the GDDR6 controllers in PHY. All this extra design work takes up significant design time and uses up large amounts of the FPGA resources. For each additional accelerator and interface, you get quadratic area growth. In the Speedster7t, the NoC takes care of all these extra pieces. The user only needs to design their accelerator and instantiate a NoC access point, or NAP. This connects directly to the NoC, which provides all the logic for address decoding, flow control, transaction arbitration, and clock domain crossing. The NoC also handles connecting to the GDDR6 controllers, so the user doesn't have to worry about placing their logic as close as possible to a large set of interface signals. This solution not only significantly reduces design time, but it also frees up FPGA resources for other parts of your design, leaving you with only linear area growth for each additional accelerator and interface. Now let's get into some more details on the features of the NoC and what it can do for you. All of our IP interfaces connect to the NoC, including GDDR6, PCIe, Ethernet, which connects to specific columns on the NoC, and DDR4. The NoC also connects to the FPGA Configuration Unit, or FCU, which allows the NoC to be used to load bit streams to the FCU that can then configure the FPGA fabric. For example, this allows the PCIe to send a bit stream over the NoC to the FCU before the FPGA fabric is even configured. These interfaces can communicate with each other using the NoC without the FPGA fabric. Additionally, the NoC extends over the FPGA fabric, providing a way to connect from IP to user logic in the FPGA, as well as point-to-point inside the fabric. The NoC runs at 2 GHz and has a 256-bit primary data path. All clock domain crossing is handled internally, along with transaction arbitration, address decoding, and address translation. So what kind of performance can you expect when using the NoC? As I mentioned earlier, the NoC runs on a 2 GHz clock and uses a 256-bit primary data path, allowing each column, each row, and the outer ring of the NoC to support 512 gigabits per second. This provides for a total of 20 terabits per second in the entire system. Specifically, the NoC supports 512 gigabits per second bidirectional bandwidth between the six crossbar switches that make up the outer ring of the NoC. 512 gigabits bidirectional bandwidth to and from the 16-lane PCIe and 256 gigabits per second on the 8-lane PCIe. We've over-provisioned the bandwidth for GDDR6 to provide support for bursts, giving us up to 288 gigabits per second bidirectional bandwidth on all 16 channels. The NoC can sustain 205 gigabits per second to and from the DDR4, plus a total of 2 terabits per second for the Ethernet max to NoC columns. It is also important to consider latency when creating a high-performance design. Traversing a row on the NoC takes 2 cycles, or 1 nanosecond, to get from one NAP to the next one on the row. And traversing a column takes 3 cycles, or 1.5 nanoseconds, to get from one NAP to the next on a column. The Speedster7t 1500 includes 80 master NAPs, which connect to a user's slave logic on columns, and 80 slave NAPs, which connect to a user's master logic on the rows. These NAPs use either the AXI4 standard interface for transactions, or can use a simple data streaming interface. The columns receive transactions from the outer portion of the NoC at the north, and the rows send transactions to the east and west. However, rows and columns are independent and do not communicate with each other. All transactions to or from GDDR6, PCIe, and DDR4 use AXI4 standard. They are simple read-or-write transactions, so a user's logic only needs to be able to send or respond to AXI4 transactions. The Ethernet MACs only connect to specific columns on the NoC and use simple packet transactions. For 200 gig or 400 gig speeds, users have a choice between quad segmented mode or a packet mode to help alleviate the need for large data paths or high frequencies in the FPGA logic. For point-to-point transactions within the FPGA fabric, there are 2 options. The AXI4 transactions between master and slave logic, which has larger latency, or a simpler data streaming transaction that works like a FIFO. To take advantage of the lower latency data streaming transactions, the transaction must occur between NAPs either on the same row or on the same column. To give you a better feel for it, let's look at how the transactions use the NoC. One common example is to have user logic in the FPGA request read data from a GDDR6 memory. Here, the master logic in the FPGA fabric sends an AXI read request east along the row to the peripheral portion of the NoC and out to the GDDR6. Next, the response from GDDR6 uses the same path in the opposite direction. Now let's look at a read request from FPGA logic to DDR4. When an AXI request initiates from the fabric, the request must always be sent to the east or west first. Next, it traverses around the peripheral ring of the NoC and out to DDR4. The response comes back using the same path in the opposite direction. Now let's look at slave logic in the FPGA fabric talking to PCIe. Here, the PCIe initiates the transaction and sends it out on the peripheral portion of the NoC and down a column to slave logic in the fabric. Any response from the FPGA slave logic simply returns up the same column back to the PCIe. Ethernet packets are similar, except they are connected directly to specific columns. Here, the packet simply goes down the column to the NAP where the FPGA's logic processes the packet. Now let's look at some fabric-to-fabric transactions. If you have master and slave logic in your design and you want to use the NAPs for AXI transactions, you can send transactions similar to the method that we saw earlier. The master logic sends the transaction out to a NoC row. It traverses the row to the peripheral portion of the NoC, and then around to the associated column and down to the slave logic. As you can see, this solution provides a method for sending transactions, but it may have larger latency. If your design requires lower latency, the best method is to use data streaming. Data streaming acts like sending data through a FIFO. The start and end points must be on the same row or column, and in this example, the NoC simply sends the data from point 1 to point 2. This also works for logic on the same column. Here, the NoC sends data from point 3 to point 4. The NoC provides an easy-to-use solution for all your high bandwidth needs. Users can easily create point-to-point connections between the IP interfaces and the FPGA fabric, all while reducing the overall FPGA resources needed and while reducing the time needed to create the design. Thank you for watching this introduction video on the NoC. If you'd like more details, please see the Speedster7t Network on Chip User Guide. And if you have any questions, you can contact us at support@achronix.com. Thank you again for choosing Achronix.